Yo, what up, guys? Welcome back to the stream, dog. Yo, let's go play Agorah. Just get up the channel real quick. Let's just go ahead and post this in the links. We're gonna be doing the overhaul. Yeah, we're fixing issues underlying that I left earlier when I went off when I had my anxiety attack. So let's just reload that. Let's get into the adventure page. Oh, I'm an idiot. Just delete that real quick. There we go. Hey, hope you're feeling better, man. I am feeling so much better. I took a nap. Never ask me again. So I took a nap. And it's kind of died down a bit. So yeah. Anyway, let's get going. I'm not gonna really think about my anxiety, to be honest, because it usually sets it off worse. So what we're gonna do, guys, is we're gonna do a few things today. We need to fix these things. Thank you for the subscriber. Thank you, Gaspar J. Thank you for the subscription, my man. Thank you. Okay, so let's get this sorted out. So this is the UI we was working on earlier. Now I'm gonna get the chat widget working today. I'm also gonna get all these settings, profiles, stores, all this kind of stuff set up. Are you? Yeah, you're correct. The size. Let me just pin these to the correct size of the screen. So we just see that there. Okay, so they should work now 100% of the time, like, well, when it comes to actually putting them into the game. So let me go ahead and show you guys what it looks like. It's what the current widget looks like. So it looks a bit bland, you know, like, but this looks so clean at the top here. So what we are going to do is we're going to add the chat box in here. Add a little icon up here, and we could do a few more things actually. We could add like a news page here. There's endless possibilities that we can do. We can add a report bug button, all that kind of stuff. So let's just get working then. So first off, let's get to create some widgets. Okay, so we're going to have to actually do it in this screen here. So we're going to do the items. health and options and stuff like that. So we're going to do the options widget. So let's set up the options bar. So usually with a game, you kind of want to do options as in you kind of want your options to be a black background. Well, I'm going to do mine as a background. So I'm going to select that there. Okay, so this is where it's going to be a bit of a pain in the butt to do. Just do that. So get below there. Ah, there we go. And obviously you don't need it to be too. Yeah, and then what I'm also going to do is I'm going to add a Gaussian blur. Kind of adds a weird gradient effect, but I'm gonna have a look what it looks like in-game. Just send that through to the chat. So let's start getting this set up. So for now, we can kind of just go with a basic, you know, inventory system or button system. Sorry. So let's do. Yeah, thank you for the subscriber, Youngblood. So let's do a few things now. I don't know, like, what options there would be. You know, we've got like size, resolution, health, That's basically it, you know? Tell you what, I want to do something real quick. So let's go save as. Because that gets covered up by the top bar. Let's just see what this looks like in-game. Blur black. We'll just have a look what it looks like as a widget on its own. And then we'll go from there. Because if it looks horrible... Keyword sounds. Okay, Britic. Yeah, it's got a blur. Okay, I messed that one up. Alright, so let's just give this a go. Go to assets. So what we do is go to this, and we'll just do, hey, click on settings, event on clicked, that's profile for some reason, I renamed it the wrong thing, let's just do create widget, get player controller, blah. There we go. So it still covers the top part of this, so we're going to just get rid of that and we can fix it through there. And I'll give it some kind of like radial, like grain effect kind of thing. But we can actually add it in a background blur to this right here. So let's go ahead and do that. Background blur. That there. Okay, so we'll also do that. See what that looks like. Settings. It's seeming to not actually blur anything, so that's not very good. Thank you for the subscribe, man. Thank you for the sub. Hey, man, I just want to say the best of luck to you and your team, and show everybody that you know what you're doing, lol. Thanks, man. Appreciate the love. Thank you so much. I don't know what's going on here. This is just like, it's weird, you know? It's, you know what? Screw it. Let's just try this, right? So let's just get rid of the image. Got the background blur, yeah? Stick that to zero. Oh. Okay, yeah, I've never worked with background blur before. I'm an idiot. I thought it was actually automatically going to blur it. Nah, I have to actually make it blur the blur. So, I'm an idiot, straight up. That's my fault there. Yeah, I'm not very bright, guys. Right. let me just fix that real quick. Yeah, you need to have a blur strength. Yeah, that does help. 0.04. Let's kind of raise it up just a little bit. Yeah, it does help to not be an idiot, you know. There we go. Cool, sweet. We are going to fix the problem, though, that I've currently got. And let's just highlight all of this. Click off of that. And delete. Stop downing on yourself. Nah, I'm all good, bro. It's all good. Yeah, I never let things get to me, because otherwise you're just not going to get anywhere, you know? I'll save. We'll just completely delete that. Import. And let's get blur back. Yes. And then let's load up the game. Click on settings, and it still does that. That's because, again, I'm not very smart. Nah, I know what the issues are. I know what the issues I'm doing. It's just blur now. So let me just lower the blur. That's the image. Can't really lower that. But you can lower the blur, though. Stop there. Sweet. Let's go and click play and profile. There you go. So it blurs this part. Keeps all of this on, and you can go back to, obviously, settings. So we can do profile, store, all this kind of tabs and all this kind of stuff. I'm going to set them all up now to work. So possible to background the blur. What do you mean? Possible to background the blur, like, what do you mean by that, dude? I'm gonna stick in some placeholders, and like some placeholder like icons and stuff like that, just to kind of layer it under the words and buttons. It is layered under the words and buttons. So if I go click play and click settings, these aren't blurred. How you doing, Hildja? How you doing, dude? Yeah, these aren't like used, you know. So yeah, so it stops off there, and that's kind of why I did the cut off here, because it cuts off the blur in this part here. So let's add some placeholders for like buttons and stuff like that. Okay, so this is where it's going to be a bit of a pain in the ass, you know, because setting it up like this is going to not really work. You know what I'm going to do, guys? I'm going to just go ahead and quickly create this button here. The only reason I'm going to do this is because I'm going to make a new one. I'm going to make a new document. Okay. We're going to call this report bug. We can get the report bug system working. Report bug. So, obviously right now there is no buttons, so we can put the report bug here or down here or like here. It doesn't really matter where, but I want it somewhere. And you also need to just completely delete all this shit. So let's replay that back, because I need to get this. So we'll get that. There we go. We'll give him a stroke. Not that kind of stroke, chat. Be on the inside, and it'll be about 2 bit Yeah, 3 pixels wide. Top right seems like a good place. Okay, we'll have a look. Report bug. So, how big is this? So, it's a 2, 4, 6. Thank you for the follow. Thank you for the sub, Witchful. Thank you so much, man. Right, so let's do... Let's get to assets. Okay, there we go. So that's in there. We go widgets. We'll go back to the main menu widget. Go back to the design. And we'll stick in another button. This one doesn't need to really be a duplicate. Report bug. Report bug. Yeah. Report bug. Okay. Sweet. No problem, man. I'm really excited for your project. Thank you, man. I needed to see 256. Wait a minute, what? Why did it do that? Oh, it's 231 by 64. Oh, okay, mad. Okay. And then by 68. So we can kind of just stick it there. And it's just going to be called report bug. Draw that as an image. Let's go report bug. Draw that as an image. And the same thing again is just report bug. I will add, obviously, animations and stuff when they're clicked. But for now, it's not really too much of a concern. So... Hey, new here, came from Britic's video. You mentioned something about releasing something to practice such learned abilities. Would this be able to be released to the fanbase prior to the game release? Yes. Absolutely. It's in the works, actually, still now. It's being rendered down into a project. Once we've got the offline servers working, then it all will work. Let me just stick that there. So there's our report bug system. So if we go ahead and click play. There's all of our stuff. So let's add some animations for when these things are hovered over, because currently they're a bit bland, have no animations, and to be honest, I kind of want some animations in there, you know? I do want some animations in there, so let's gonna get these animations in. So you go down here, click animation, play hover, and then you do track, and you just use play. Be of scale, and then 0.30 seconds. We're just gonna like increase the scale on both the Y and the Z axis. I'd love to know whether there's a Q&A with your team. We haven't had one. We've not done one yet, man. And it's just the one. Yeah, what's up? Alright. Guys, let me... I've got my... I'm gonna have to go for a second, guys. I didn't really plan this through, did I? right. Okay, well, let's carry on. And then I'm gonna put the stream onto, like, just a quick 5-minute break. I'm gonna play some Paragon gameplay, and then I'll be back. I don't care when or how long it takes, I'd love to see. No wonder, man, no problem. Let's get this animation... Let's get this animation plugged into the graph. So let's do... On event hovered... Play animation. And then the animation in selection is going to be called play hover. And that should work. So let's give it a go. There you go. It's not fine-tuned. Still needs a large thing, you know, like, still needs to be still needs to be like properly properly done. But that's like the basics of what's going to be going on. I'll tell you what we were actually going to do before I do that real quick. I'm just going to move these down to about 0.15 and then 0.30. So that way the animation plays a lot quicker and smoother. So that, that you can just do this. And it works. It gives you a feedback that you're actually hovering over something. And it's all cool. So what we're actually going to do is we're going to do that for all of them. It's fairly simple to do. Just duplicate it. And we'll just call it store hover. And instead of having the play icon, we just change replace with store. And then go ahead and click play. And it doesn't work. on console, no matter how long it takes, but I'll wait. But I accidentally sent the message. Oh, okay. Yeah, console will be coming. Console is in the works. Just going to keep duplicating these. I'm going to call this one settings hover. And then the same thing goes on again. You just replace with profile. That shouldn't be called profile, but it is. So it's there now because I can't. I'll fix it in a later date. And let me just duplicate one more time. Profile hover. And replace with settings. So we can even do it for the bug report as well. So we will do that actually. Bug report. Tell you what, we're going to do bug reports a little differently. Bug report. We're going to do his more on a slides to the left situation. You know what? I'm going to do this. This is going to be so sick. So let's do... make this selection, and we'll do this in a white. Just rasterize the layer and make that white. So. Okay, so we'll do something like that because now this is where. So that's clean. Okay, chat. This is where the clean crisp comes in. Alright, so we're gonna save this because I'm gonna close it real quick. Go back to assets, import, and we're gonna get the report bug back. Yes and yes. And then we're gonna go back to the widgets. Now it's not gonna be as refined because I need to Ctrl-C. It's just a little bigger, and then what's this? So we're gonna do just like that, okay? You know what? Actually, you know, maybe we should just leave it like that for now. We'll give it the same Same one. We'll give it the same as every other one actually at the moment. Report bug. Okay. And then profile, and just replace with report bug. So they all should work now. Just got to wire them in. So let's go and wire them all in. So we got store on hovered. Play animation. The animation. Design. Settings. Animation, and that is called I believe that should be correct. Save. Go back. So then play animation, and the animation is called profile hover, and that should be good. And then the final one to obviously do is just the report bug. On hovered, we're just going to do another play animation. Oh, and that's report. So, before I go, guys, I'm going to go for dinner in a second. Just go ahead and wire this all up. There we go. So, there you go, boys. Don't know if it's me, but your mic seems a bit quiet. It might just be you, to be honest, dude. My mic's spiking at about 40 decibels, so. But there you go, guys. There is the works, dude. Sick. We got it working. We got animations playing from it. Unfortunately, this widget does then interfere with this. So, I'm going to have to think about how that works, but we'll work on that a little bit later. I'm gonna just go get some food, guys. I'm gonna set up a Paragon gameplay video for you guys to watch while I'm gone, and then I'll be right back. Okay, so let's do Paragon gameplay. We'll give you some gameplay to watch, guys, just while I'm gone. I'll only be 5 minutes, so I'll let you play the video.
Peggy 18.
Okay, well, that's a Peggy 18 game, apparently. Okay. let me just add a text to the screen, guys, just saying I'm going to be BRB eating. No, it's not very professional, but there's not much I can do. We'll stick up this gameplay for you guys to watch. We'll just stick it to the other monitor. We'll just do this.
What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? We're back with some more Paragon
in a second, then, guys.
This time.
See you soon.
Gonna start with Rejuvenator because I'm not too sure about my supports. Considering I think I'm pretty certain they've disabled matchmaking rating, so it doesn't matter what level you are, you get matched with anyone. So, or maybe it's just because the queues are so long. What I want to do actually, turn this health bar off, and bar, do this. Nice. My Muriel knows what she's doing. Lamplighter and Rejuvenator. She knows. Not a demolitionist. Ooh, got that handstand, I see. She has no support, so we can just chill. Haven't unlocked anything because obviously if she steps up, I'm gonna have to give it that rewind. I think I blocked the last hit there. Yeah, she's on zero. It's pretty nice. Blocked all her CS so far. Amira went Coin Master so we can make good trades here. Ah, the minions came across. Ooh, it's out of range. She needs to be careful. Fuck. So close. I think she has to go back though. She used mana for no reason, that's nice. She started to shield up, I thought it would drop by the time. Potion here again, grab the gold. I'll back once I have enough for Invader Mage. Oh, if she landed that Q, I could have killed her. Fuck. Gonna go back anyways. So let's just... Oh fuck, I thought that was Kwong. It's actually our Muriel. Oh, I can't go back here actually. Nice try. Oh, she just gave me enough. Thank you. Alright, so what we want to do is I need to pick Font of Experience up. And Invader Mage. So this is perfect. Come on, give me health and mana. Nice. 1725. Decent, decent. I think she went and took my gold. Lovely. I'm gonna push the wave kick gadgets here. And I think she's invis. It's kind of pointless, but okay. Ooh, the jump shots. Oh, what the hell? Just run. Oh, we're gonna get knocked up here. Nice. Ah! Oh, fuck. I'm so dead.
Welcome to sitelootbear.com. For here is the best place to rent out skins, buy skins, and sell skins. My friends, Lootbear is most trusted marketplace on internet for skins. Have you ever wanted to use good knife and become better player, but cannot afford full price of monies? Then Lootbear is for you. You want to become supplier and earn up to $5,000 a week renting out your skins? Then Lootbear is for you. Let's say I want to rent skin. If person renting does not return item, they send hitman.
Alright, nope, I'm gonna take it from here. Fucking hell, okay. It's super, super safe. There's a really high intense security
I didn't realize
system.
It was
as a brief
advert.
Example,
how
if I'm gonna rent
a
skin,
before,
then
guys?
I have to tick all.
Oh, shoot, dude.
I should have just left them. Why did I try and save them?
Alright. Let's get back to working.
Tarek, the game's not available yet, man. We're developing it on these streams. I didn't know it was on an advert, okay? Okay, so let's get some stuff working then. Let's get some character movements, I think. Shall we? Here we go, good play. Okay. Oh, okay, cool. Should we set up some characters? Fuck it, because I was actually going to work on Shinbi, wasn't I? So let's do Shinbi's. Go to Monolith 1, I believe it is. Yeah, I know. I just thought because you guys like Paragon, I was like, I'll stick that there. It did say BRB eating, so I did that to kind of just break the thing. Let's delete the texting. Yeah, actually, yeah, probably is a bad idea to do that. Sorry, guys. Next time, I'll stick a big red text box at the bottom saying, do not, this is not my game. This probably isn't the right map. I just need a map. I don't care what one it is. Good work with Bridic, by the way. I also thought it was for a moment until I saw the BRB eating. Yeah. Sorry, man. Yeah, to be fair, it wasn't the best, smartest idea. Okay, yeah, this was the foundations for the first map. Cool. So let's stick in specific characters. Should we do Shinbi? Oh, I wanted to fix Wukong's double jump because I broke it. I didn't break it, but I'll show you in a second, guys, what's wrong with his double jump. It's not as fine-tuned as it could essentially be. So I'm going to run. I'll run you through that and show you guys how it works. So it does take mana, but currently there's no UI to, you know, indicate that mana's gone. So, but like, we'll look for it and have a look, make sure this all works. Thank you to everybody who's new, man, around here. We really appreciate you guys. Okay, so this is obviously Wukong. I don't think he possesses... Oh, he has a weird lock. I need to remove that. I was doing some tests with the angle camera. So, like, you know, like this. Yeah, I've been playing a lot of Smite lately. I would definitely recommend a Jail-style game. Single lane 3v3 with a small jungle if you're still game mode feedback. Yeah, we actually were looking at that. Jail would be quite a funny one to do. But anyway, we'll get that sorted out, actually. I can start designing a map for that today. So we need to remove Wukong's lock view. That's really broken. That's as much as I can go. So I need to remove that. But this is his double jump. So I need to have a blend transition at the end. And this does take mana. It takes 100 or 200 mana, I think it is. Yeah, we'll do the... we can do Jail style. Definitely. So his double jump does work. It doesn't really work if he's flipping backwards. So that's something I do need to obviously do. So I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to do a blend space, I think. I think it would be... Okay, so... Okay, that's a bug. So yeah, I think we do a blend space. In terms of development, it would be the easiest to finish and polish too. I mean, it's not the problem with the, you know, how long it takes to get it fixed. It's more on the lines of it working in general, you know, because we do have those issues. We should do all the best I was worried about. Do you okay? Gideon, I got you, brother. I got you. Yeah, they were leaving Wukong out, and the only reason is they got to do for the three lanes, five first. That's a major. Yeah, that's the majority of the fan base is like, we want that. Yeah, okay. So apparently, don't have collision on there. That's interesting. So let's actually do something. I'm just running around with Wukong to answering your questions, and I really should not be doing that. I appreciate your work, brother. Thank you, man. Thank you, Peter. So let's go ahead and let's fix Wukong's jump ability. Wukong. Stick his animation blueprint. So I'd imagine it's depending on which way he is. He has that delayed fall. I don't remember that slow fall unless you're referring to that with the blend space. Yeah, that's what I'm referring to. So I don't know how Wukong's double jump actually was because I can't remember. So let me go back. Let me go get a YouTube video real quick. Wukong double jump. Because apparently he shouldn't have that. He should not have that much, you know, of a weird fall like he currently does. So I'm going to just refresh my memory. Do you have a Facebook link, mate? Loving what you're doing. No, we have a Twitter, though. If you go to @PlayAgorah on Twitter, there you go. That's it. It's quick, like, full gravity effect. Okay, sweet. Okay, thanks for that. So I think what that would be is just a simple change of... it's because he can run on the air, isn't it? Yeah, so I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to allow Wukong to run on the air. Let's do it. Depends on the stance. Wukong jumps in death stance. And air walks. Off he does the pole. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, so I'm actually thinking of doing... Let's set up the air run. See if we can do that. So, let's... It'll basically just be like a static mesh. Like a massive static mesh that Wukong can just walk on. That should essentially just be it. So I'm trying to think, because when you double jump, you can air run, right? You can't just double jump without the air run. Am I correct in saying that, guys? Here's a link to his ability tree. No, I've got it on my other monitor, mate. I've seen it. No, you could drop, I think. Yeah, just gonna send someone a file, guys, real quick. Twitter.com. So, this is where obviously all the problems arise, right? Because I'm gonna try and set his gravity scale. I think it was like a hold button to keep while walking. Okay. Gotcha. Just send him these files. Guys, can you can't drop a file. Let me send him a logo. Okay. So in attack mode, you had double jump, slam. In defense, he had airwalk. Okay. So this is going to be a little annoying because I don't have the technology yet for that. I do have it, but I mean, I don't. Okay. It's an interesting one. All right. Tell you what then, we're gonna just try and play with his air run. So is there like a feature where I can set the player's gravity? Get player movement, and then is it like, can we do like set gravity? There we go. So set gravity scale to 0. Sweet. So if we do, so we press Q on the keyboard, Wukong should now no longer have a gravity scale. So let's do... Okay, so that's... get it, kind of... Okay, Maybe we need to tone that down a bit, you know? So not bad, but not good. Can you not do gravity and a ceiling cap? Yeah, I think we do a ceiling cap. I don't think a ceiling cap is a thing, is it? Box component, is it movement capabilities to the variables? I don't think it is called a ceiling cap, is it? I imagine it's not. I don't know if it can be done from separate from the world cap. Maybe we use roof. I don't know. Restricted. I don't know. Okay. So there is another way we can obviously do this. Oh, so he literally has zero gravity. Ah, okay. You know what? I'm actually just gonna completely delete that. We're gonna do another thing. We're gonna just do a static box mesh, I think. It makes it so much easier. Let's just do a blueprint class, an actor, Wukong Air. Thank you for the sub, man. Let's do Wukong Air. Let's just get a box collision and extend it out. So we'll allow him to run any plane direction for... I really want it to just be he can only run in a straight line. So we'll try with that. And that's going to block all. And what it's going to do is we do Wukong Air. And if you press Q in the air, obviously it won't be on Q, but we're going to use Q as my debug. We're going to spawn actor. Okay, it's not spawning. Spawn actor. Context app from class. Just watch Britic interview. Hey man. Get socket transform for the mesh, and the socket is going to be right underscore foot. Is it R foot R? It might be foot R actually. Foot underscore R. We'll soon find out. always spawn ignore collisions. Yep. And we're going to set a delay. No, actually, tell you what, we can do all that from the actual actor itself. So let's do initial time span. We'll say 10 seconds. So we should, in theory, now have this working. As if you compile the errors. What's wrong with this? Where's the error coming in? What is your error? You seem to have an error. What is your error? spawn actor none. Oh, I didn't put a fucking spawn actor. Uh-oh. I didn't put a Wukong. Oh, there we go. Alright, so we do jump. And it kind of pushes him away, right? It's there. So it is above him. Interesting. So. It's an interesting one. So what we're going to do is we're going to... This is where, obviously, trial and error comes in. This is going to be interesting. It's going to be an interesting one to work with. You know what? I'm going to leave his double jump out of it for now. I'm going to just leave that. We'll get back to this. So I'm just going to delete it and we'll get back to it. Instead, we're going to work on some other animations for him. So we've got animations. What other attacks has he got? He's got primary melee, Q flip full loop. Oh, Q full loop. Oh, nice. uh, Alright. I'm looking for my notes. Please, all we want is Legacy and Agorah. I got you, fam. I got you. By the way, this isn't actually my map. My map's being built. it's just like, yeah, it is being built still, so. Who's sending me friend requests? Gideon, I'll accept. Oh, aye, mate. Listen. I want Agorah back and Legacy, okay? I don't want Monolith. Monolith is, ugh. Okay, this map's just my test map. Don't worry about it, guys. So I meant to load this up. No. That's just broken. Interesting. We're gonna close Wukong Air as well. Main menu widget. Don't think that really needs to be touched upon. I mean, it can do, but I don't think it's necessary. At the moment, but not everybody wants Legacy. There were elements from both maps that worked well. Yeah, definitely. We're going to be going for both of the game modes, definitely with the elements. One of the main things is everyone was like, the characters don't fit for Legacy. Some of them aren't there for Legacy. To that, all I say is, yeah, cool. they're not meant to be, you know? Why don't you join the Metabuff team and help them make the game now? Because we all have different ideas, and I don't think Metabuff actually are doing anything in particular. They do it in their free time. I do this as my full-time job, or full-time thing. Targeting loop. I don't know you could target people. Push up. RMB. So this is my left mouse button. The mid lane is being a zigzag in Monolith was a good thing, for example. Yeah, so I'm going to get in contact with my admins, and we're going to get on our map building team. Yeah, so Edom, Metabuff, in my opinion, I don't think they're doing enough to meet the demands. They do it in their free time, and I've already completed all this in like a day. Like, I've already got UIs set up, all of that stuff, you know? So, it's like, Metabuff as a team, they're not doing enough. And that's why I don't want to merge with them. How do you feel about Ethereal? Ethereal's not to do with Paragon, so to be honest, it's not really too much of my concern. I'll tell you what, though. Ethereal are doing a fucking amazing job. Ethereal are very good, from what I've seen. Were you inspired by other MOBAs? Yeah. Smite was a big one. Smite was a big one originally, and then I was like, nah, Paragon. so this is being a bit weird. So it says RMB, which is like, right mouse button. So it's being a bit of a silly one. it's being a bit silly. I'm kind of stuck. I don't know. I kind of want to do a recall to base, but I don't really want to do that. Once my Paragon Smite was unplayable for me, honestly. Combat mode additive. Let's just click on that. Let's have a look. So that's when he goes into combat mode. Thank you, MG. Thank you for the follow. There's some characters from League that are similar to Paragon ones. Shen's ultimate is the same as Mural's. Lux's ultimate is similar to Murdoch's. Yeah, a lot of them do that, though. Yo, thank you guys so much for the subs, dude. You guys are mad. Okay, so we're going to go... I mean, yeah, it was definitely one of those things, you know? trying to face tests. Why do I need to know about face tests? I don't care. Front end future king. So these are the front ends. Hit react front idle. Sorry, I'm still getting to grips with the naming system. Fortnite Epic Games didn't really do a very good job with the naming system for these things. Balance that monkey. Dude, honestly. Okay, I'm honestly just doing nothing right now, and I'm kind of annoyed with myself. So let's get some stuff done. Melee C slow montage. Melee slow recovery. So we can do... I need to think of which one... Oh, there's a slam. Sweet. Okay, let's just use that. Do you plan on bringing back harvesters? Wait, guys, can I just ask, is that normal? Is it normal for his thing to be that big? Is this normal? Somebody just tell me. I'd imagine it is, because Epic Games did the animation. But, I don't know. Yeah, that's normal? Okay. It looks so out of place. Like, it just doesn't look like it should be there. Okay, it didn't look normal to me, alright? Alright. So the slam works, sweet. Let's just get that queued into something then. His pole pose to get big. Yeah. Okay. Let's get his blend. Oh, his animation blueprint's already open. Animation graph. Yeah, we're gonna do cast to Sun Wukong. Yeah, I know the one that he stands in front grows. And as this, we want to... what animation is that? Ah, here you go. So it's Q Slam. That might be the small one. That might be the one that we're going for. Yeah, I'd imagine we'll work with it. We'll get it in, get it working first, and then go from there. So, I'm gonna call this slam. Oops, sorry, slam. We're going to get slam. Yeah, I'm not very. And then we'll rename this one slam with a question mark and do that. When will we be releasing? We want to get a playable version out in 4 weeks for you guys. Okay, for some reason this isn't working. Let me just read the suggestion. So, we're going to be hoping to get something out in a few weeks. Like I said to Britic, we're going to get a playable version out. And within the next few days, I'm going to get a client out for you guys to test characters. I just kind of run around like a gray space, attacking things, minion attacks, all that kind of stuff. Minions won't work, but they will sit AFK, and you can keep hitting them. Quote unquote playable, more like pre-alpha quality, I'm assuming. Yes. But it shouldn't be too bad. I'm kind of one of those people that has to have it good before I release it, otherwise I won't release it to you guys. So slam. Alright, so let's do the event graph. Fuck, where's his animation blueprint? Locomotion. So we've got, that doesn't need to be there. Animation graph. So it's aim offsets. Oh, wait, no, that might actually be right. Yeah, okay. add a state called slam. I paid Alpha Paragon when the minions were all identical in grayscale. So I don't mind. Okay, cool. We want to have a chance to go back as well. So we just want to do get slam. There you go. And when you come back, you need to do a equal gets. Okay, and then add in that. Let's just get slam. And then we'll do Q. And we'll do Q set slam. Just give this a bit of a try. Hey, sweet. So it's gonna constantly loop. That's all good. add a delay. And the delay is roughly about 0.5 seconds in. And then we're gonna set slam to off. Cute. Okay, maybe a little longer than that. We're also going to disable his input as well. He can't move while he's doing his slam. So we're going to disable the input as well. So do set slam. Obviously this isn't going to be his thing. So it's going to be disable movement, character movement. Set that to there. That should stop me from moving, right? Let's have a look. Yeah, there you go. So you can't move. But I believe you can still look around though. Yeah, you can still look around. You can't move. And then enable set movement mode to love using Wukong and using that jump slam attack too slow and chase enemies. So that should be good. Although I have a feeling it's not going to do what I need it to do, is it? Let's have a look. Cues, you can't move. And then you can move again. Hey, there you go. So you do jump. Okay, so it's going to, obviously, we're going to do the jump because he needs to fall. So we're going to make him jump and then slam into the ground. So it'll be an animation montage. I just wanted to get the animation working first before I did any of those sort of changes. I just wanted to have those working before I did anything else. Let me send this guy the icon file super quick. Okay. Let's go back to my chat. Nice. Yeah, so we're going to do the animation montage. Just making my montage. So, Q slam is a... So, I basically want him to jump first. Then do the Q slams. So, that's going to be our montage, basically. So, let's get that working. So, where's his jump apex? Let's... We got jump start, then jump apex, and then the slam. So let's do create animation montage. Gonna be honest, I don't know what I'm doing. we'll keep them in there, but I don't know what I'm doing with those. Let's see if there is actual an offset for these. He has an AO blend space already. Okay, so this is depending on where he looks, right? Okay, I like that. That's cool. Cool. We can work with that. We can work with that, chat. That's something that obviously can be worked with. So yeah, let's do that. That'd be cool. Would Richter be one of the 12 characters playable on launch? Probably not. I mean, would you guys pay though? That's the thing I'm trying to, like, the reason I wanted to make it free originally is because would you guys pay? You know what I mean? Like, that's what the issue is. People were like, well, we don't know if we want to pay. But I mean, okay, then space. It's not gonna be fun at all. Wukong's double jump. He has to jump first, right? Yeah, that's why I was gonna go with free. If you guys do want to help out with money wise, you can always donate. You don't have to, but if obviously you want us to succeed and help us out, that's great. Hey, Friesen, how you doing, man? Right, so let's set this up, because I'm not really doing it very well. So what we're going to do real quick is we're going to move the input node. We can move this down a little bit. Spawn emitter at location. underscore R. Yeah, he jumps and then he can also double jump for that slam attack. Okay, cool. So what we do is I'll set up the particles and stuff and then I'll work on the double jump because that's going to be the hardest thing for me because I'm not used to doing that at all. Is Nightbot in the chat? Let me get my little Nightbot out, dude. Let's get my little Nightbot dude out. he should be here. He might not. Let's see. Is Nightbot gonna come in? Nightbot doesn't seem to want to be here today. let's give him some actual commands, I think. Yes, we've got support and then Discord. Let's see if that works. Let's make sure my Discord. Can't we support you with mining link, like donating with CPU power? What does that mean? What's mining link? Are you talking about for server wise and stuff like that? Thank you for the subscription, man. Thank you. I don't know what you mean, dude. Hold on a sec, guys. Just gonna reload my stream super quick. If you guys are talking about servers, we actually have a server base. We have a server rig set up already. Hold on a sec. We have we outsource our server rigs, so we don't obviously have our own. We don't use our own PCs for the servers like what Core and Predecessor did. They did for their alpha. Well, for Predecessor, sorry, they did their own PC connection. We actually outsource our servers. We use a Steam subset, so yeah. Sorry, I was meant to be doing something. Animations, that's what I was doing. Yeah, so that's all good. Listen, guys, you don't need to pay. Money is not required. I'm not doing this. Well, I'm doing it for financial gain, but I care more about the community than the money at the moment. You know what I mean? Like, I care more about you guys than I care about the money for this, you know? That's what I'm saying. Money is... It's nice if you want to donate, and that's a very nice thing to do, but it's not required. Alright, let's get this up. Wukong. Paragon Wukong effects. Here we go. Mesh. Mesh heroes. There we go. Shockwave. So it doesn't seem to have a texture. So let's give that a texture. Thanks, man. Poggers. particles. Oh, it's materials, right? Heroes. So... We're now doing game store. Yeah, dude, doing game stores. We're planning to get something out for release, but I don't know what I'll be able to do. I can't promise anything for in game stores, obviously. I'm trying to think which one it is, dude. Is it this? It's got to be that, right? That's got to be the material. You know, it's got to be a shockwave material. So let's just. Oh fuck! I just broke it. It's got to be a shockwave material, so let's just do shockwave. M basic shockwave. Maybe that's what it is. You keep saying you don't care about the money and want to build a strong community first, and I really appreciate this, but how long you don't care about money, I wonder. Because pretty, I think that you guys will succeed. I think when we start having a consistent player base, that's when we'll start saying, all right, yeah, let's start making profit from this, you know? Because I want to be able to make a profit from this, guys, to buy, to save up for a car. Yeah, right now it's about building the game, but I am in it for the financial gain. And I'm also in it for the experience, because I want to go to a games company and be like, oh, that's what I made, man. You know what I mean? Or I'm just going to keep running my own company. Thank you for the follow, my dude. Thank you, Rob. Thank you for the follow, man. Ooh. Okay, so that's the basic shockwave. Okay. I don't think that's the right one. So we're just going to go off on another one. We're going to do another shockwave. Let's just save this. And let's see what happens. So it's called. You're a mesh, aren't you? Fuck. Go with the God Pack idea, free game, buy heroes. Easy way to buy base, to get base money. I don't want to do that though. I don't want you have to go and buy characters. That's not what I want this game to be. I don't want it to be where the player has to purchase to be good at the game. We don't do that here. Instead it would be skins, cosmetics, and booster packs. Easily down for $10 for early access. I'll tell you what, we'll do this, guys. All right, $10 purchases. We'll sign up on our site. Okay, James, you just fancy him. Get 5 free or whatever, and then you can purchase the rest. But it's all, but this is all way too early, lol. Yeah, I mean, what I'll do is, if you guys really want to have an early access before anyone else, I'll set something up, okay? I'll set something up on the site. So if you guys genuinely want to have early access, what I'll do is, I believe on the website there is actually an early access purchasable game mode, game version, sorry. Refunds will be included. So if you, I paid $100 for the full pack for Paragon, I'd buy it for me and a bunch of friends at $10. That's good to hear. I'm glad you feel the way about paid content. I don't like the paid content, and I want the players to, I want new players to come on and be equally as matched as players who've been playing for years, you know what I mean? I don't want it to become where the player has, like, you know, absolute trash, because they can't buy the game because they ain't got the money, you know? I don't want that. A game dev being forced to take money. Dude, honestly, it's like, I didn't expect this shit. Alright, do you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna set some cup on the site super quick, real quick, guys. Gonna quickly make a page with a PayPal button that's completely secured, okay? Yeah, so what we've got is we'll release this version in on the 5th of July, okay? When the trailer releases, we'll launch this version for alpha testers. If you buy the game, we do $10, right? You buy it for $10, you can get a refund if you really dislike the choice you made. We will refund those. I'll quickly make this page just for you guys, because you guys clearly want this, and I'm like, I don't really want to add it, but you know what, we'll do it, guys. So let's do early access. Thank you, man, for the subscription. I mean, okay, we'll do that. Yeah, let's do that. Let's add a PayPal button in. Yeah, so what we'll do is I'm going to set up the site now, and then I'm going to link it in the chat, guys. And if you want to purchase the game as an early access, you get it on the 5th of July, okay? You'll get a client and it will work. It won't be on servers. There will be no dedicated servers on the 5th of July. I do need to make that clear. Or there might be. If we make enough money, the opposite of EA, if we make enough money, the servers will be up by the 5th of July. Yeah, thank you for the subscription, man. The servers will be up on the 5th of July and we can get them up. So let me just quickly do this super quick. It's going to be a super ghetto thing. I'll make it look a little bit nicer a little later on down the road, guys. Purchase early access. Okay. Text. Dude, the opposite of EA, honestly. To be honest, the sooner the better. Hey, hey, having Paragon cravings, but of course, game comes first. Looking to pull more people. So we're gonna. I'm literally just about to release the website up. You guys can buy early access. So hold a minute. Okay, here we go. Yep, and Grimdark. Y'all remember Murdoch critting like 2,000. Oh, God. Yep, and good, but that was later on. You should do no refunds, so you would really only get those players to purchase early access who know what and how you were doing. What's early access? We already streamed or no? Yeah, you can stream early access. That's the nice thing about paid early access. Randoms are not going to get jumped in and get scared away. It'll probably be. Okay, so do you not. Okay, let's not do a refund then. I mean, if someone really does come to me and go, hey, I misclicked, I didn't mean to, oh, I made a terrible decision, please, can I get a refund? I'm not going to be a dick about it. I'm going to be, you know, we can sort out an arrangement. What is the product's name? Agorah Early Access. Want to add an ID number? No. What's the price? So should we do $10, guys? $10? Would you guys say $10 maybe? Let them email and ask for one. Do we not work in GBP here? Yeah, we do. We can do great rich pounds. Adding in refund could possibly cost you money as well for service fees. Okay, yeah, true. Okay, so we'd do $10 or £10 or 10 whatever your currency is in your country. So let's have a look. Obviously I'm in the UK, so we'll do, what's the price? 10. What is the currency? We'll do £10. So no, we'll do dollars because pounds are cheaper than dollars. Opens in a new window and language is in English. So let's preview real quick. PayPal will refund the 2.9% fee as well. You are already talking about money and you've not proved that you can make a game. No, dude, Anthony, they only want, people want to have the early access alpha, and we'll do refunds if we don't end up releasing the game. You'll get your full money back. We're not gonna scam people like that. The work ethic is great. Support low. PS4 pretty decent community. Enjoy Paragon. So I'm gonna let them talk about this. $10 sounds good. $10 is okay, I think, because it's not much. You won't get a lot of refund requests, and it don't hurt your soul because you don't want to do this. I really don't want to do this, dude. You guys are fucking pressuring me. All right, let's go to my store real quick. Early access. All right, guys, it's up. Let's just link you to the site. Early access starts July 5th. Refunds will be given back if we do not meet this deadline. I'm just going to copy that message. So, if we don't meet the deadlines, then refunds will be given back. Paragon was in development for years and years with the massive dev team. These small teams using already made assets and they're just trying to make a buck. Selling the game to access the game is horrible. Anthem, another notch. I actually didn't want to do this. These guys in the chat pressured me into doing this. When did you start learning Unreal Engine? I started learning back when it was UE3 still. I'd wait to actual gameplay in a trailer before buying early access. You know what? That's completely fine. Or if it was in Steam, I'd feel much more comfortable buying. Because we're a licensed company and we then don't because it's a bad loom. It's not particularly, my man. By the way, do you stream every day? Because if every day is going to be like this, you won't get much of a game done. I don't stream every day, no. let me go back to the main menu widget because I want to work on the UIs and stuff like that. Maps. Shit, I didn't even think this through, did I? Another notch, he never asked, he opposed the idea. I never, like, dude, having that early access payment doesn't leave any bad stain on me. And it's a completely mandatory, it's a completely user-based decision. You don't need to buy anything, you can wait for gameplay. If you want to buy anything, you can buy it. We've already said, legally, refunds will be given out for people who, if we don't meet the deadlines. Yeah, that link is to pay for early access, yes. It's $10, $10. I understand how it works. Yeah, like, it is a complete choice. You don't have to pay. If you do, you have that option. You know what I mean? It's just, people want it, and they get it a month early. So, you know what? That's cool. I completely forgot I had Wukong working like this. Yeah, it's not really good. We go click play. Release on Epic Games Store? No, go away. okay, why is it doing this? Ah, because I'm an idiot. Sorry, hold on. Main menu, there we go. So we click play. So this is still, it's got a texture pool. Dude, and don't pay then another notch. Yeah, just don't pay if you don't want to play it. Or if you want to wait for gameplay, then do it, you know? It's not something that I'm going to be going off going, you need to pay to play, oh my god. So, this one's, right, so we got report bug, play, store, settings, profile, report bug. So I want to kind of make everything look a little bit cleaner, to be honest. How are we getting notified of a client in order to pay the account, sorry, the email that you use on the site, will tell me who has a game. And also it should, tell me when you purchased the game, what email you used. So whatever email you used when buying the game should do it. I'll quit pressuring you now, lol. it should work like that. Let me have a look real quick. Just making sure this isn't showing off my screen. Okay. So if I sign in on my PayPal, right? You can also use... Oh, that's not even my account. Sorry, my bad. You don't even need to use PayPal. I think you can use card. But I don't... Oh. Yeah, so... You can sign in using PayPal, and then your PayPal email... I was about to use a different PayPal account. The account that you're using, the PayPal that you use... got a Discord link handy? Discord, it should work. Nightbot's meant to be here. He doesn't want to be here for some reason. I'll explain in a second, man. So yeah, the email that you use for the PayPal, you'll get an email on that. In the game, what card system? Legacy. Wait, so you're charging for early access? Yes. $10 if you want to play on July 5th. If not, just wait till... Yeah, yes. If not, just wait till August and it'll be out. I mean, you guys use a card system or an item system. Cards. PayPal account 100% has to match the same account used to create Blue Jedi Games account. No, doesn't have to. Yeah, what's up? Okay. It won't split the community much. The best one will gain all the support, most likely. Yeah, definitely, for sure. Bro, honestly, dog. It doesn't need to, I don't think. You said you would never charge money. No. We said we're never charging money to play the game. Early access, we are charging money for. But that's because the community want that, not me. I didn't ask you guys for the money. The community, you guys said it. We made him charge. Yo, Carl, it is completely your choice whether you pay to play the game, okay? You can just wait till August and the game will come out for free. Legit, you were trying to make a quick buck. So I'm actually making a game, you know what I mean, dude? Like, right, let's just work on the UI system. I bet it won't come out in August. Sure, buddy. We've already got most of the stuff done. We actually said if it doesn't come out on July 5th, for those who pay, they get refunds. Nope, because they get refunds, dog. If it doesn't meet the deadlines, they get refunded everything. It's not like, he said refund. Yeah, you're an idiot for buying into this, sure. Carl, are you aware how much of a legal problem it is if I do not actually stick to that, right? Mm-hmm. You already changed the Discord? I reset the Discord for a reason. William, why did you pay twice, dog? I might refund the first one. It's not a legal problem. It is a legal problem. So how long have you been actually working on this? 7 months. Dude, I'm gonna refund your first one, I think, William. No, I reset the Discord because it was a mess, dog. Carl, buddy, like, I'm not going to bother responding to you. It's... People can choose to buy the game. You know what I mean? You don't need to play the game if you don't want to play the game. You don't need to buy the game if you don't want to buy the game, okay? If you want to buy the game, you can buy the game. If you don't want to buy the game, please stop trolling my chat. William, whoever's William's account, please can you message me? Carl needs a ban or needs to chill. Tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to just go ahead and put him into timeout. Okay, William, I'll refund your first one, man. Not now. So I'll decline the first transaction and I'll accept the second transaction. You paid twice, yeah. You paid $210, so I'm just going to go ahead and refund the first one. Decline. Just decline that. Submit. There you go. So that's the first one's declined. Payment was refused because it did not meet the payment. Did not accept payments in this currency. What? Oh my god, man. Refuse payment method. Paid twice. Refunded. Refuse payment. There we go. Maybe I double click confirm, though. Have you got Kamira working in. She was my main jungler? No, not yet. Bing has Wukong, Iggy, and Scorch. Chimera was my main as well. Chimera is a nice one. I love Chimera, to be honest. Let's return to my account. And then let's accept this first one. Thank you, William. Thank you for the follow, man. My mom's calling me, guys. Hold on. Okay, I'm back. There you go. So, you need mods for the streams? I do need mods for the streams. I'm going to actually set up a thing where people can do that. I'm not at all that worried about it. What, the refund? Nah, I wanted to refund it anyway. For the release in August, will you possibly have Revenant figured out? Revenant's going to be figured out for the 5th of July. Revenant's going to be ready for release. Revenant's quite easy, to be honest. His logic is basic. What type of announced audio? The original Paragon one. Yes, cross-platform is coming. When are you planning on releasing the game to Steam? We want to use Steam's subsystem, but not the actual client. You are competing against two other Paragon rival teams and called them out for not doing much, and you're going to get some trash people in the stream soon. Oh yeah, I'm aware. I'm gonna let you drop. I'm gonna let the game drop then. If it's okay, $. Yeah, that's fine. Hey James, just watch Agorah the surprise Paragon and has some questions to ask. If I do, yeah, what's up? And then this guy, want to call soon? Want to show you something? Can't streaming to 30 people. show the game. Show me the game right now, as is. Sock, buddy. I'm not ready to show you because so this is currently our main menu widget. It's so basic because I need to actually. That's what I was actually figuring out how to do. This dude has really given me so much hope back for Paragon. I think it would be good to sleep tonight. You got my support, brother. Super stoked. Hope everybody comes out. See, the thing is, you're going to get people in the chat who are going to be... Yeah. So, you're going to get... why aren't you ready? Because it's not on this computer. I've been doing the UI widgets today, dude. Like, I don't have... I have three computers. So, I've got the main PC, which is this one here. And I've got one down there, which works on my code, and I've got my laptop. Most of the game is done on my laptop. So, I've done a few movements. How many NHLs can you play 5th of July? There's 12. I'll run you through them in a second. I'll tell you what, I'll do sock up just a little bit of a closure. Okay, well, show us the game later on today. You know what? I will, actually. Do you want to see it later on today? I can show you. I can show you what I've currently got with a few characters. I've changed their movement pawns, so they should... work a little bit better now. Run through the map. The map's not built yet. Colin, my map developer's building a map for us still. If you look in the Discord, his name's Donut. He's still making us a map. What platforms are you playing on? Oh, big, small. Once the map is built, we'll run through it. How much do you have patent? How much do you have patent? Patent? Do you mean patented? You don't need to have much patented. We've got the names and everything else patented. And towards how many you're playing in the editor? Yes. I didn't know I was playing in the editor. What about client prediction? How will you handle it? Also, is this in GAS? Yes, in GIS. Yeah, GAS. Client prediction? I don't know. Do you have servers? Yes, we have servers. We have servers in the UK, or in the EU, sorry. They're hosted in Amsterdam, and we get them. We've got some US servers currently hosted in Arizona and Michigan. Is the map going to be small for the characters? Going to run after a while from moving. No, SOCAP isn't an alt account of Carl. Our servers are hosted from... sorry. SOCAP is a content creator? Yeah, no, he is a streamer. Sorry, what am I doing? I'm so blinded here. Our servers are basically off of a web host that we rent off servers. They cost me like 50 to 60 quid a month, so... you know, we need East Coast servers 1000%, dude. East Coast is coming. Honestly, I know your pain. West Coast is worse, dude. West Coast is like, we're gonna get central servers. I'm thinking of doing a central server base. So if I go ahead and just run through the map, oh, it's not gonna work, is it? How many do you have? What servers? They, SOCAP, do you know how servers work for games? Wait, are you charging money for this now? Yeah, you can buy the alpha. Early access. You can buy early access and you get it on July 5th. You can play on July 5th. It will be ready to play on July 5th. But it's not mandatory. You don't need to pay. You don't need to do that. You don't need to pay for it. That makes sense. I didn't want to. The fucking community pushed me into it, okay? Literally, it was in my chat for like 10 minutes just constantly. I'm gonna spawn in Wukong. So you rent a server for a game for 10 people for 5v5. No. So what it is you pay a fee. I pay 60 quid and I get certain gigabyte data of servers. So that's up RAM and all that kind of stuff, right? Do you have a plan for having a website? We have a website. Go to bluejellygames.com. So depending on how many you will have playing, you will need to spend a pretty good amount. No. So each game... Larry, we've actually offering refunds if we don't reach those deadlines. It does say on the thing, if deadlines aren't met, you will be refunded. So if we don't reach the deadline, you get your money back straight away. So say like if you pay for the alpha and it doesn't come out, you get refunded. So this is how it currently works. You just gotta do like this. How do you not know about client prediction? If you know, I didn't say I don't know what client prediction is. It's all good, buddy. Just let us do our stuff, man. Okay, you literally said, I don't know. Oh, did I? I didn't mean to say that. I do know what client prediction is, it's just, I don't know, man. Thank you guys so much for the subs, man. Thank you guys. Give the guy a break, he's got 100 questions coming in, LMAO, honestly. Is the alpha later on going to be free? Yeah. You guys hiring? If so, yes. Sorry, guys. This is kind of now just becoming a little conversation stream. We're going to just have some talk while I'm still working in the background. On my other monitor. I'm still making UIs. Tell you what, should we make the inventory HUD, guys? Make the inventory HUD? Fuck it, let's make the inventory HUD. Rob, we have been following this guy for months. He's consistently lied and make grand claims. I mean, you haven't been following me for months. It doesn't make any sense. I haven't been up for months, you know, to the community. I haven't, anyway. Yeah, no, but SOCAP, the reason we've actually went on to Britic's stream is to say, hey, we're actually doing this, and this is my full-time career, in a way, you know what I mean? I'm doing this constantly. This isn't, like, something, like, in my hobby. This is like full time. I work day in, day out on this stuff. You know, like I don't sit there. You know, I don't just sit there and like do this like in my free time. I do this like every day. I wake up 6 a.m. every morning and I get to work. You know what I mean, dude? It's like, it's just how it is, man. It's just how it works. Right, let's work on the UI. So, should we do a rounded one? You already finished college and you're 18? Yeah, in the UK you can finish it whenever. I got a level 3 degree, so I can finish. It doesn't work the same as it is in the US, my man. It works a lot differently. And anyone from the UK would know what I'm on about, you know. In the UK, you don't have to be a certain age to leave college. You could, if you, as long as you pass. You finish college early in the UK, yeah. So, you could be donating everything you have to children in need, and people would still be mad at my man. Dude, honestly, you know what? I'm gonna do that. Fuck it. Let's do. You know what it is, man? It's fine. You know, people are gonna hate because they don't see shit. But like, why would I be streaming constantly? You know what I mean? If you have some devs in your Iggy stream who actually work on projects asking you all kinds of questions, you can answer them. I don't like answering questions, to be honest, man. To be honest, SockApp, I've got very... as weird as it is, I have social anxiety. And the questions, when people start throwing questions at me, in a kind of confronting manner, I don't usually answer them because it kind of stresses me out a little bit. That's completely up my fault in a way, but it's just, you know. How much does it help as a company? A lot. You don't like it because you don't know the answers. I mean, that's completely not true. I'm skeptical. We're very hopeful to see what you guys do. Thank you. And it's like I said, guys, you don't need to pay. Nobody needs to do anything, you know. Not gonna ask you to pay for anything, guys. That's too light, isn't it? I don't like that. So when I have about, you know, devs like coming at me, asking me all these questions, like, yeah, it's cool. A lot of my devs know a lot of the stuff that I don't. Oh, shit, dog. This guy's sick. Yo, guys, I'm going to show you the new... My guy revamped our logo. There's not, where are they? They've not seen them stated more than, you stated more, 2 more people. You haven't seen them because they're not in the Discord server. We've never seen them or heard from them. You probably won't. You'll hear from them within the next few weeks because we've got Cameron coming on. The attacks are unneeded, man. If you don't like what he's doing, then bug off. Yeah, I mean, it is what it is. SockUp, who's paying you for being insensitive? If you watch Brit Extreme, there's 5 devs. No, not what he told us. Lol, no one. What? Oh, what? 5 devs? We got 5 devs. So we got... No, 6 devs. Did I say 5 devs on this stream? Sorry, I missed out. did lie to multiple times, 2 others. Yep. Okay. Did you outsource things like you mentioned in Brit's video? Is team of 6 you have or additional? 2 of them are additional. The others are my friends that have coding degrees. He said he would never charge. No, I did not say I would never charge. I said for the full game, I will never charge money. Okay? Oh, did I say six? Alright, cool. Yeah, I thought I said six. No, sock app. The full game is not charged. I had no intent on releasing the game. He still hasn't asked for money. What are we talking about? I haven't asked for any of the money. I did not ask for money. The chat made me. Okay, you lied to you, dude. They kill your family and drown your child. The community convinced him to charge $10 to play the game before August lol. So perhaps you were in the stream when we asked him to charge money. I love how people are getting mad about you for offering per day. Oh my god, it's so annoying. Okay, let's focus on something else. Let's focus on something else. Okay. You know what, I'm gonna ignore it, dude. We're just gonna keep doing it. Thank you for the sub, man. Alright, we're gonna just gonna work on the game. Right, let's get some stuff done here. So let's do okay, man. Thank you for your kind words. And I fucked up, didn't I? Oh, no, I didn't. Oh, mad. Okay, cool. Is that visible though? Yeah, it is a little bit visible. Just make it a bit shorter. Make it just a little bit shorter, and let's stick it in the middle. There is, I believe. It says instant. Yeah, purchase game early access, instant access to developer server up before anyone else. A cool prefix for your name. Maybe I should actually write something in there. Yeah. Okay, I'll sort that out. Yeah, okay. The cinematic trailer is coming out on the 5th, yeah. Yes, back to working on the game. Yeah, back to working on the game. Oh, okay, yeah, I'll add that in a second. Hold on 1 minute, guys. Just, okay, I don't like that color. Let's open the game. Stop streaming and get to work. How you doing, Helmo? Welcome to the stream, buddy. Oh, good sir. Right, let's fuck it. I'm gonna take the health bar I had before. This thing down here. Oh no, I'm an idiot. What am I doing? Oh, that's Q. Did I press Q? I meant to press W. Oh god. Oh, got so sidetracked. What were you eyeballing? Am I working on HUD inventory? HUD. Sweet. And then we'll go with two different kind of light purples. So let's slip that there. There we go. To be honest, I don't actually. Yeah, okay. I don't know if I'm really happy with that, to be honest. There you go. That's more like it. This is going to get working as well, so we're going to get it working in-game today. In the next, like, half an hour. So we're going to get this working today. To one that Core made? Probably not. We kind of want to go with the original Legacy one. That was what I wanted to do, so. So there's health, there's mana. Each of those dark ticks is a percent value. Just ticks is a it's just to kind of show you guys that you have, yeah, it is basically a percentage value, I think. I can't really tell until I get in game. Each of those dot, yeah, so I don't know, man. It is what it is, I guess. Each of the, yeah, so I think at the moment it's a percentage tick, but I need to have a look. So, let's get working with this. It wouldn't be so bad if it weren't for the fact your composition needs to be more completed so far with better polish. Of course, you'll quickly catch up considering your project is full time. I wouldn't really say that they have more done than we do. Purely for the fact that they have work done, but a lot of them have given up in a way. I mean, I don't know about Predecessor, but I know that Metabuff have come back, but people are starting to lose hope with them. Jeez, you have copied that inform what? Jeez, dude, you have copied that in from Word. Are you talking to me? Fuck it, I already have a UI. What am I doing? Wait, I already have a health bar UI, don't I? Where is it? Let me... HUD. Here we go. Hey, there we go. So we've already got this sorted out, so... Oh, yeah, probably has, dog. So we've got QER, left mouse button, right mouse button. I should probably make that. Can I make these like on top of the widget? Right click. Oh, they are actually just that. They are actually just that long. Isn't Metabuff a full-blown studio? Metabuff is a full-blown studio. No, they don't have 60-plus people. Do they? Mad. Yeah, they can't release gameplay. Interesting. They actually know what they're doing. Yeah, okay, so we don't know what we're doing, apparently. We just... Yeah, true. Hold on a sec. Just doing a rough outline at the moment. Guys, like, I understand everybody's concerns, right? And I said this on the stream, you know, and I was like, yeah, I mean, I understand everybody's, like, what Mongoose did? I didn't even see Mongoose's comment, to be honest. Card-based health, left click. Where the fuck is it? Ah, it's game states. See, yeah, true. The thing is, dude, yeah, Britic, I would wait as well, but I mean, I didn't want to put that out there. The community guys, you guys wanted me to put that out there, so I mean, it's completely down to you guys whether you purchase it. I mean, I don't really care whether you purchase it or not. Oh, my voice is so... Oh, dude, I hate when it does that. But I'm just doing this because people really liked this look. So we're going to use the old original Paragon one. Paragon did it that way. They patched in map upgrades as they go, especially Monolith. Monolith was good. I mean, Monolith was also... fucking terrible. 11 minutes ago? Oh, he just made a new one. Yeah, Britic, that's all good. Do you guys want to see the new logo? Yeah, just wait to see what happens, guys. You know what I mean? I'm not obviously saying anybody, you go play alpha, go pay for the alpha, do all this kind of stuff. Just do what you want, you know what I mean? This is the new logo. And then this is the banner. My artist is so cool, guys. Go, guys, if you guys want, go drop this guy a follow on Twitter. Okay. Go drop this guy a follow on Twitter if you guys want to. We're going to change all these banners and stuff over. Yeah, I mean, Britic, like I said, dude, like, I didn't want to put it out there. I actually didn't want to put the alpha out there for purchase, but the community literally spammed me in my comments. They were like, yeah, put an alpha out, $10, just so that if there are people who want to pay, they can pay. And I'm like, okay. Do you know what, dude? Like, I'm not even going to bother with all the hate, to be honest, because if this game flops, it flops. If the community decide, hey, we don't like this dude, I can't stop that, but I just advise, you know, what I advise. Alright, we're going to... Oh, okay. Alright, so let's just... We have to do individual peng tools. Isn't that good? Isn't that lovely? I hate doing this. This is like... And I'll polish it all up. By game progress, I was talking about the impressions we get as viewers. Probably the main cause for this map and graphics. If we focus on gameplay things other than visual, that's better. Yeah, we don't really... Not 100% too concerned about visuals just yet. I'll color those in afterwards with a pen. Chimera going to be out in the alpha? Probably. I need to reevaluate with Chimera. I was playing with her and him, sorry, and it's just I fucked it up a bit. Anyway, off to the start, Sockap. It's almost like you told Mongoose what to say. He didn't ask for donations. Mongoose says he's asking for a lot of donations. He's wrong. Mongoose making false claims. Mongoose is making false claims? We'll sue him then. Item system or card system? Card. Card system. Straight up card system. I don't like item systems because although you have those items and they work. Yeah, but Sockap, I never once asked for a donation. I never asked for a donation from anyone. doesn't do what he wants. Like, you realize I have no. I still call smite item cards, lol. Wait, I wouldn't say never ask for a donor. No, we never said openly, we're gonna go off and say you need to pay. I saw something in Discord about your Streamlabs. Oh, no, people asked how can we donate, and we said that is the current way. But I never went out and said, donate. My chat was just like, yeah, donate. Like, I want to pay for this game. Anyway, that's that. So, I'll do them all up afterwards and just kind of make sure they're all 100% thing. We're going to completely get rid of this. I'm an idiot. Delete that. Not in the stream yet. Yeah, so Britic, it was, I never asked in the streams, they just said, it was like, can people pay for this to get it early? He's not asking, but it is available, that's basically how everyone... Yeah, it's not asking, it's available if you want to buy it. Right, so let's set up this. I have to actually make triangles. Ugh. Okay. Thank you for the follow, man. It's fine, dude. Right, that's... both companies have way of making money. The streamers, they donate. People donate to the streamers. Like, the guys that make, Predecessor, sorry, are streaming the development, right? And yeah, Smokey, and that's how they make money. So, this is essentially the same way, dude. Okay. Yeah, you donate to Smokey because you're wanting to get the game early or you want to play the game. It's the same way as this. We're giving you something in return for helping us out. If you want to bitch about it, then, dude, this community is not for you, dude. You know, you're the you seem to be, and like a handful of you seem to be the only people who, you know, have issues with it all. That was their choice. What's wrong with him? Given an option, it's not on demand. It's not a way to play a game. No, it's, I mean, but we're giving you something in return for donating. I'm sorry, would you rather you get nothing for doing it? What, you, yeah, okay, right. Sockap, Yeah, I'll refund you if it doesn't work, you know? Fuck it, I'm just going to delete that for now. We're not even going to have that on the screen. Like I said, if the deadline doesn't meet, you get refunded. If the game... We've made that clear as well in Thoth. Right, let's... we've also made that clear. We said that you do not pay it. You do not have to pay. It's not mandatory. I mean, would you rather not... Would you rather pay and guarantee access or not? Like... Can we have the coin meter and XP bar like in Paragon and toggle it through options? Yes. Send that through to suggestions. Okay, guys. Well, the ones who do want to pay, you can pay. I'm going to leave it now. Hey, Larry. How you doing, man? I think it's deceptive. Donating is not buying to pay. It's not a Kickstarter. No, it's not donating to pay, dude. It's not donation. It's through our website. It's not through our Twitch or through our stream. Okay, we're going to leave it. We're going to leave it now. Let's get this working. Let's get this UI up in the game. I'm going to just completely delete everything that's not relevant at the moment to the game. And now I can't get rid of that because I'm an idiot. Ah! Rasterize that layer. Fuck. Shit. Delete. Delete. This game stats. I'm an idiot. What? Oh, it's card base. I'm an idiot. Isn't this HUD copyrighted though? No, I don't think it is, because we're not. This is a remake. It's not the original one from Paragon. Yeah. You guys have proof of concept. I don't think we might do actually. Yeah. So this is a remake of the original one. Yeah, no, it looks just like it, but if I see, you can completely delete them and they've all been remade. I have a fixed property. It's a copy of the HUD, yeah. We might redo it all though, because all of this is not allowed. So it's obviously just proof of work at the moment. It's not actually gonna be the official one. So I hope that clears that up with you guys. So it's proof of concept at the moment. Wait, you said it wasn't an issue? He just said it wasn't an issue? No. It is an issue, but like... Yeah, you know what, Sawcap? You gotta make a game, dog. Like, dog, come on, bro. You know what, dude? It's like, sock up. Like, buddy, I get the community's distraught with what happened to Paragon. I get that, okay? But, like, you just need to realize, man, the community is backing me here. You just need to realize, stop being negative with it all. You're not gonna like get anywhere. Just, you know what I mean, being negative. Just, bro, like, honestly. Take yourself elsewhere. Let me do my developing. Otherwise, this game will never be able to be released, dude. Have you seen Rocket Mania's project? I have. I think you should... Rocket Mania quit. I think you should change the HUD completely. One of the few things I was a fan of with Paragon. Okay, let's completely restart from fresh then. Thank you for the subscriber, man. Yeah, Rocket... I mean, I'm talking to his map developer, is my map developer, so... I mean, he quit, you know? Overthrow was a portfolio piece and it worked. Yeah, no, it was a portfolio piece, but he wanted to make it commercial. His map developer is my developer. The guy who develops his map is the same guy who develops my map. Speaking of my map, actually, you guys get to see that pretty soon. Where did my drink go? I'm lost. So Rocket Mania, Rocket's map dev is yours? Yeah, we've got one of his map devs. You guys should bring back travel mode on legacy map. Yeah, travel map is coming. Yeah, travel mode is coming. Or he worked with Rocket Mania. So he didn't really work, I don't know if he did the official designs, but I know that he did work on the project. Donut should be... I believe it is. No. Let me message him. Hold on. Did you work with Rocket Mania? It's called Donut. It's the guy called Donut. I know there's a few people that worked on Rocket Mania. You don't have this guy that developed the map. Oh, who's this? James, I played like 10... Yes, I will. So you don't actually know. He said he did, and I saw his portfolio piece, and he's done some really good work. So I would imagine he's not lying, to be honest, considering the work I've seen. Yeah, I'm asking him now. I just messaged him. Yeah, I think he told me on a call yesterday. Yeah, guys, please stop asking me questions. VG developer? Is your map developer fan? VG... no, he's one of our main developers. Well, one main map thing. Okay, guys, I'm not answering these questions because, to be honest, I'm not getting work done. So we're gonna make the HUD. Let's get everything set up. Oops, sorry. Just want to go back a few paces. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to cut back on the streams. Okay. So why won't you answer them? Because I need to get work done. Same one from Paragon. Let's just completely delete that. Really? Thank you, man. Stick up the health. Yo, Sevrog, how do I... born, he likes... He is like a... habitual liar, no joke. Cool. Does it matter? Just see how much... how this plays out. Just... can you guys... Alright. Because of their stolen work? How is this all stolen? Okay, you know what, man? I'm gonna just, like... I'm sick of this, dude. I'm gonna cut down from the streams, I think, dude. Where the hell is the mana bar? Oh, it's there. It's a bit of a weird one. You know, I'm gonna get my moderators in here. I'm gonna get my mods here. Hey, can you... Let me call up my moderator real quick. Joyce Senator, how are we not doing anything legally? Epic Games released assets for us to use commercially. What about client prediction? We're going to smooth it out as much as possible. Thumbs down, the intellectual property stolen scum. What intellectual property? Epic Games literally released everything we're using. You can't use those assets and charge for it? Yes, you can. So, you have to pay them royalties. We pay Epic Games royalties for using those assets once we make a certain amount of money. Speaking of which, actually, I'm going to get in contact with Epic Games about that. It's 5% royalty, I believe. People not understanding what's going on, calling you. If that's the case, then we just renew it all. We'll refund it all. Using the card art from Epic Games tool? No. Epic Games released some of their assets, not the entirety of the project. No. We're only using the assets they've released. Can we can expect a POC. Yep. Epic definitely did not release the HUD. No, that's why I'm redoing the HUD. Yeah, no, that's why I'm going to redo the HUD. Yeah, we're only using what they released that we can use commercially. Yeah, except for the HUD. So we're not. That's why I'm redoing the HUD. let's just move this up. There we go. Fuck it, do you know what? Let's just get... Where's Crosshair? Yeah, okay. I didn't actually realize the legal properties of that. No, you're not. When can we expect a pot? Pretty soon, my man. So now that's changed too. Alright, so, dude, listen, dude. I need my mods here. What it did before the game shut down? You talking about sounds? We have our own sound effects. We have our own sound effect guy. Fuck it. I'm gonna start making some people mods in this chat. We're complaining because he's legit stealing intellectual property. Brother, please explain to me how I'm taking intellectual property. We have the right to use this. I didn't charge anyone. No, Sevrock, I'm good. can just remove his roll real quick. But all I need is Severog, honestly. We're going to recreate it all, because we don't want to have a lawsuit on our hands. We're going to try and recreate as much as possible, because, to be honest, man, we don't want to have a lawsuit. But the only things we're using for Epic are the things they've released commercially, okay? The money that was sent through, the people that have bought, quote-unquote, early access, right, is a donation-based system. It's not to do with anything else. It's to help the game, and in return, you will get the early access earlier. That does not mean you're paying for the game itself. Okay? Think you'll get refunded? Because it says, well, they can fucking sue me if I don't. Don't have to make money off something to steal it. It happens in academics all the time. People lose literally millions of dollars from the nonsense every day. Every year. No. You're a scam and a fraud? I mean, I'm not really, dog. Like, I'm making a game. Like. No, we're not recreating the... Dude, how many times do I have to tell the community, right? We are not copying Paragon. Dox yourself? See, the issue is, though, dude, like, when people bring out claims like I'm a fraud, that then puts me in legal problems because you've got... You were just okay, dude. Oh my god. Oof. Okay, I'm not. Explain in a cohesive manner, dude. Yeah, I never wanted to release. This is why I didn't want to release a paid version of the game, dude. What did Rob once say? Don't release a paid version of the game? Well, when you've got fucking 27 people spamming your chat saying they want a paid version of the game, you're gonna go ahead and do that because you gotta meet the demand, dude. It's not one of those things that, by the way, my UE force frozen. It's not one of those things that's that easy, you know? I don't think a lot of you guys really understand the position I'm in. Like, I don't think you guys understand. I'm not, okay. Hold on, yeah, yo. Guys, so both of those games, right, Core and Predecessor, you're donating to the developers, right? People are donating all the time to the developers, so why the fuck do you not give them the shit that you're giving me? Yeah, I can't steal what's released freely to the public. Proper legal avenues? We followed proper legal avenues. I wouldn't read chat, just do your thing, make your game. Well, I'm waiting for UE4 to stop being frozen. Core haven't merged and they haven't even given us a release. Yeah. That actually caused a lot of problems in the community, actually. I remember when that became a thing. They take donations as their developers and streamers. I'm doing this as a stream, not a company. This is not this the way of making money at the moment is not for streams. It's through the streaming. It's not through the game. Okay, let's just completely work on this. If the money doesn't matter, then why is everyone bitching about it? I'm not recreating it anymore. I won't do that. Still have the option to buy stuff. If you know. Okay. I'm getting my moderator in. I've got my mod in, guys, so she's gonna start removing people who are trolling. Right, so let's get this working, get the trolls out. Yeah, but my mod's coming in. Right, so let's work on this. What are we doing? No, it's not Amy, it's Haley, actually. Get your facts right. I'm gonna just do this real quick. Is she in the chat? Gonna stream my stream about that? I'll strike you. The site never got shut down. Yo, Haley, can you please type in the chat, please, so I can give you the moderator rank? Thank you. Right. Oh, there you go. Thank you. Let me just give you moderator. There you go. Thanks, hey. All right. Because you're buying a hoodie, you're getting something real in return to supporting a real company. We're a real company. We're licensed. I didn't fake a death. That brother, like, you don't fuck with that, Larry. Yo, you don't. Yo, hey, can you start banning people? Can you get rid of Larry? Fuck it, I'm gonna just do it. I'm gonna put him into a timeout first. Haley, start putting trolls and people in here, like, into just timeouts. Bye, Soccap. Bye, buddy. He's gonna ban you entirely from the channel, I think. Gonna stick you in there as well. Alright, dude, that's way out of line. You don't ever fucking do that. Okay, I can't remember what I was working on. Thanks, guys. Oh, yeah, I know what I was working on. I was working on this. Hold on a sec. Okay, the site's been updated, guys. Yeah, that's enough. We're not using their system. We're not using their designs. We're using our own. Hey, Haley, can you get rid of Joyce? Joyce Center Gaming, please? Just put him into a timeout. Real YouTubers know that this guy's a fraud. Listen to us. Buddy, fraud means someone who is faking to exploit money. Okay? Can you also get rid of Carl as well, please? Thank you. No, I'm not going back to HUD. Actually, no, I am going back to HUD. Sorry, my bad. All right, let's get to HUD working. I'm going to just let Haley do this and sort out this stuff. So am I not doing that? Am I not doing what? We've updated the site, guys, to, just to say that it's a donation-based system now. I'm not going to ban the entire channel. Okay, you know what, man? I swear that Core released a Founders Pack. So now is it not a purchase on the website? It's a donation. Are you crawled? Okay, Haley, can you just leave these guys? Let's just sort out this. So, we get a mini-map set up a little bit later on. For now, I'll do... Yeah, I'm going to make the HUD. Let's kind of do... So, this is where your cards are going to be? Oh, okay, Core's not selling a foundation pack. I don't know that. I just wanted to know, like, hey, are they selling foundation? I know they said they were accepting something. It was in one of their comments. I replied to somebody. I'll try and find it and dig it back up to show you guys. But it's all good anyway. Let's just copy that. Oh, wrong one. I thought they did. Thanks, Haley. Okay, so we need to have kind of a cool... I'm going to go with a cool, like, rustic kind of look, right? So... Oh, dog. Fuck it, dude. Let's have an octagon. Oh, no, this isn't an octagon, is it? It's like a pentagon kind of shit. I just find it quite sad, to be honest. I don't really like that. Minimap next in the HUD. Can't do the minimap until the map's built. Because minimap, you have to trace over your current map. Fuck it, you know what, we're gonna do a circle. Nope. That'll be your level. Your weasel level man, oh god. Dude, you know what? I don't even know who's who at this point. Haley's just going to start deleting the same guys that keep coming back. It's all good. We're going to just... Oh, crap. Didn't really think that through. No, we ban people that we ban people that are trolls and that are purposely trying to manipulate the audience that we have. Shut up, Haley. Haley, type in the chat, please, because my phone's gonna die. Oh man, I don't know. Okay, so that's the card. That's where the cards are gonna be, right? So this is where your cards that you pick are gonna be stored. He will not have a real legit game available for July 5th unless Epic is paying for a revive game. This, but isn't HUD design done on pen and paper first? Usually not, to be honest. Yeah, this UI is going to be very different. That's fine, Apollos. I mean, to be fair though, No Man's Sky was the worst shit ever. Uh, I wouldn't do it on pen and paper, to be honest. Let's just do pen. Fuck it, I'm just gonna get the health bar and mana stuff working. Hold on, guys. Don't, bro, I've not been able to do any fucking work. Because all you guys do is shit talk it. You know what I mean? I do one thing and you fucking... Okay, Brudek, thanks, dog. Alright, cool. Brittick's watching the stream on his own stream. Interesting. It's one way to lose him. Dude, it's fine. Yeah, can you see? Yeah, true. Honestly. Just gonna straight up ban stock up. Alright guys, I think I'm probably gonna just end the development stream, to be honest. Because I've been streaming for 4 hours. Sorry for the swearing, guys. I've been streaming for 3 hours. I'm probably just going to end it because Brittick's streaming this himself to try and get those views. I'm going to work off stream because that way, you know. How many people have you had to ban so far? It's just the same guy constantly on different alt accounts. We're making our own one, Mike. I didn't change the name of the company. We changed the name of the game. Yeah, I will post my progress off stream on the thing. Yeah, sure, Severog, I will. Yeah, guys, I'm gonna just go ahead and end the stream because obviously Brittick's streaming this himself. Thank you to the guy who sent me that. I'm gonna head off. I'm gonna stream tomorrow, guys. And I'll show you the progress I've made tomorrow. I'm gonna release a lot of progress tomorrow. I'm gonna have actual attacks done tonight. So I'll leave that in the Discord. I'll stream tomorrow with the actual development of characters and finished characters. I will have 2 characters finished to show you guys tomorrow. And that's working, not just animations, and a damage system. Promise you that. I'll see you guys tomorrow. If you guys want to donate for the alpha access, it's still available to do so. It's not required, not mandatory. Please don't do it. Nice excuse. What? Sounds good. Take care. Dude, can't wait. Good luck. Look forward to seeing you. Oh, Brittick's fault? Nah, it's not Brittick's fault. Don't like being taken the piss out on stream, though. That's not very nice. So, like I said, I'm going to get the gameplay working tomorrow, and I'll have some stuff to show you guys, because I know a lot of you guys are eager to see it. Thank you, guys. We've been on about 40 viewers for a very long time. Thank you, guys, so much for the support. Thank you to everybody who's sent us stuff. And if you guys have any fan art or any work that you want to send us, send it via Twitter. We'll post it on our Twitter page. Thank you guys so much for watching the stream. You guys are all great. Bye.